Hello, good evening. Hi, hi.
Good evening, teacher.
Hi, guys. All right, very good. So I see Beatriz, William. Hello, William. Gonzalo, hello.
Luis hello, teacher.
Alfonso, good evening. Carlos Escobar, Carlos Antonio, Dinora. Very good. Alex, Edwin, Carlita. Very good. Excellent.
Hi, teacher.
Hi, Carlita. How are you?
I'm fine. You?
I am very happy it's Friday, Carla.
Yes.
Yeah, very good. Yes, we deserve a break.
Yes.
What I'm
very
mean?
Happy for that. Hi, Jose Eduardo. How are you?
Hi. Bien, teacher.
Yeah, you're fine. Very good. Okay. Very good, okay.
Y los demás compañeros dicen que no se pueden conectar, teacher, ahí en el grupo.
¿Por qué?
No sé, dicen como que se han cambiado la... Ahí están, va a demandar en el grupo.
Because it's Friday.
No, aquí estamos todos.
Todos, bueno. Ya fue más temprano.
Qué raro, ¿por qué no podrán conectarse? ¿A ustedes no les dio problema? Vea, ¿se le dio
problema? No, a mí no, teacher.
Maybe because it's Friday.
No. I know. Elizabeth no puede, vea así. Ya logró entrar. Elmer está entrando ahorita. Judith no ha logrado entrar. I don't know. Okay, bueno, esperemos que logren entrar porque no se ha cambiado nada. Todo es normal. All right, guys, very good. So remember that today is the day before last, okay? So we're not gonna, we don't have classes Monday, but we will have classes Tuesday because of last Monday. Así es que los vamos a volver a ver el martes, que es el día que vamos a realizar la encuesta. Solo recordarles que la encuesta no la hagan, si ya la recibieron, no la hagan todavía, okay? La vamos a hacer el martes. Okay, because that's the last day. All right, ya entró Judith, very good. Y ve Luis Manuel también, he's driving. Okay. Hay música por ahí ahora. All right, guys, very good. So I'm gonna take attendance. No sé si me hacen el favor con ese micrófono que tiene música, no soy yo. Hola, no soy yo. No. I don't know what's going on. Okay, Lizzie, ¿me escuchan?
Sí, teacher.
All right.
Yes, teacher.
What is that? Okay. All right, very good. Let's see. Alex Humberto Saldaña Rodriguez.
Present, teacher.
Thank you, good Alex. Evening. Good evening. All right, very good. Then we have Ana Beatriz Pineda.
Present.
Thank you, Bea. All right, very good. We have Ana Judith Portillo Bautista.
Present, present, present.
Thank
present.
You. ¿Qué le pasó? ¿No podía entrar?
Desde el cel estoy.
Ah, that's why. All right, let's see. Blanca Elizabeth Alvarenga Mejía. Blanquita y Blanca. Oh, no. All right, let's see. Carlos Alfredo Portillo Núñez.
I'm here.
Thank you, Carlos Alfredo. Carlos Antonio Escobar Hernández.
Present.
Very good. Hey, Dinora Alejandra Alfaro Corea.
Present, teacher.
Edwin Valmore Flores Gómez.
Present.
Elmer Ubaldo Ramírez Cruz.
Present.
Thank you. Francisca Elizabeth Martínez Gámez. Gonzalo Valle Valle.
Present, teacher.
Thank you, Gonzalo. José Eduardo Guzmán Álvarez.
Present, teacher.
Very good. José Galileo Barrera Hernández. Okay. Carla Marisol Escobar Arbaiza.
Present.
Luis Alfonso Martínez Pérez.
Present, teacher.
Luis Manuel Muñoz Acevedo.
Present, teacher.
Thank you, Luis. Very good. Norma Lizer Quintana Mancilla. Olga Marina Contreras Acosta.
Present.
William Mauricio González García.
I'm here.
Thank you. All right. Yolanda Melanie Pérez Enríquez. Ada Karina Cruz García. And Ana Karin Solis López. All right, very good. Dinora, do you know if Galileo is going to be able to be in class?
I think he's in Azulta.
Oh.
And I don't know if he will connect.
Okay, all right, that's okay. All right, hopefully he will because it's like the last 2 days, like today and Tuesday. All right, so text him and tell him I say so. All right, very good, guys. So remember that we are almost finishing, okay? So yesterday we were talking, we were using the book. So let's go back to the book. Okay, let's see what we have there. I'm just going to share the book with you guys right now. We are in page 42, I believe. Let's see. Okay, so yesterday we were talking about could, okay? Decíamos ayer que con el verbo modal could, ¿qué podemos hacer con ese verbo? Do you guys remember? What can we do with could?
But
no?
I don't remember. It's for a question.
Uh-huh. It's a question, yes. Mm-hmm. It's a question because we are doing what?
Okay.
Okay, what else do we remember?
In Spanish, teacher.
No, Carlita. No, Carlita. No Spanish. No, me va a sangrar. All right. Ajá, Carlita. Try in English, Carla. Huh?
Evening.
Good evening, Galileo. All right, Carlita.
Para solicitar algo. No sé cómo se dice la palabra.
Ah, pero ahí está, Carlita. Mire, ahí se lo puse. Léalo, léalo. To make polite, ¿qué dice ahí?
Yeah. Request.
Request, Alex. Yes. Very good. Yes, Carlita. Okay, very nice. To make polite request, that's why we use could. Okay, to make polite request. Por eso decía Luis Alfonso, que es for asking questions. All right? So, could you, could she, could they, could we, all right? So, it's a polite way to request, okay? So, that's what we were talking about yesterday. A ver, voy a dejar de compartir un segundo aquí. Let's see, William. If I use could, ¿dónde está William? Ahí está. If I use could, William, do I make any changes to the verb? Not, William. If I talk about he, she, or it.
No, teacher.
No.
No lleva S.
Okay, no S, right? Okay, yeah, it doesn't have an S. Okay.
Sorry.
No, that's okay. Perfect. Okay, Carlos Antonio, why no S for he, she, it? Carlitos?
Excuse me.
Okay, William, me acaba de decir, yes, William just told me that no S for he, she, it, when we use could, why not?
No remember.
You don't remember? Mm-hmm.
Because don't have any chain.
Why, Alex? Because we're using what, Alex?
Because don't have any chain.
Ajá, y no tiene cambio, ¿por qué? Porque estamos usando un qué.
Un modal verb.
Excellent, Alex. Very good. A modal verb. Could, right? So when you use could, no change for there's no change for he, she, it. Okay. So could you, could he go, could she take, could, I don't know, could Olga help me, all right? So we're not using, we use nothing for the verb, all right? Because we use could. All right, very good. Let's see, tenemos un micrófono encendido y no sé si me ayudan a apagarlo, please. Thank you. All right, okay. Okay, so yesterday that's what we were talking about, okay? Could. Entonces, regresamos aquí y decíamos que lo usamos to make polite requests, and then we read this whole conversation, okay? Yes? Hola?
¿Cómo tenemos los micrófonos apagados, teacher?
No, yo no los he apagado, pero me las pueden hacer a ti. Para ver que no estén congelados. Excellent, William. Yes, 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 yes. Very good. Okay. So here. Did we finish this yesterday? Could you write this? ¿Vimos esto ayer? Just remind me. I can't remember right now.
No.
No, right? Thank you, Bea. No, okay. Sure. So, very good. Yeah, because we saw my presentation. Okay. So how to use could for polite and formal requests. Okay. Galileo, para darle la bienvenida a Galileo. Ajá, Galileo, can you read this, please? Lo que está en azulito y lo que yo sombré ahí.
Yes. The modal verb could is used for polite and formal requests.
Okay.
Structure. Could plus subject plus verb base form plus complement plus
question mark.
Question mark.
Plus question mark. Very good, Galileo. Thank you. Okay. Mire aquí, está en paréntesis y dice base form. All right. Because nothing happens to the verb. Okay. So we're not going to use anything. Examples. Alex, can you read the first example, please?
Could you write this report, please?
Could you write these reports, please? Very good. Yes, thank you. Okay, very good. Gonzalo, can you read example number two?
Could you deliver this letter today, please?
Yes, could you deliver these letters today? Okay, so we have could, we have subject plus the verb, base form plus the complement, and of course you have the question mark. That is very important. Okay, now do you have any questions about the use of could?
No.
No questions. Very good, Bea. Very nice. All right. Okay, now today we're going to continue talking about the use of can. Can is another modal verb. Okay, ahora, solo voy a dejar, voy a hacer un alto aquí. Cuando hablamos de verbos modales, por ejemplo, can, can is a modal verb. Okay, the modal verb can has different meanings or different usages. For example, si usted dice, I can swim, or I can speak English, or I can, I don't know, ride a bike. Hablamos, sí, el can es un verbo modal, pero su significado en esas oraciones que les acabo de decir es de habilidad, ¿ok? Cuando yo le digo, I can swim, de hecho no puedo, pero digamos que sí, I can swim, all right? That's an ability. I can speak English, eso sí puedo, all right? I can speak English, it's an ability, all right? Ahora, puedo también poder, puedo usar también el can, y le puedo decir, Alex, can I talk to you? All right. Or can I go to the bathroom? Entonces también podemos usar el can, no solo for ability, but for permission. Okay. Si de repente usted recibe una llamada y me dice, teacher, can I answer the phone? Apaga su cámara. O me dice, can I turn my camera off? You ask for permission. So it's ability, permission. But right now we are studying the use of can for requests. Muy similar al could, la diferencia es formalidad, es un poco menos formal que el could. All right, yo le puedo decir, Galileo, can you help me? All right, porque lo conozco y es mi amigo, yo le digo, can you help me? Pero en el caso que no fuéramos tan amigos o tan conocidos, or he's my superior, all right, I would say, could you help me? All right, o no lo conozco, no hay mucha confianza, entonces could. But we know each other, all right, so I say, can you help me, Galileo? All right, so that is less formal, no es que sea, no es falta de respeto para nada, pero sí es un poco menos formal. Okay, ahora el significado pretty much is the same. En su momento, ustedes van a ver can for ability and can for permission. No van a decir, la teacher no nos dijo. ¿Cómo no? Depende del contexto, así lo vamos a usar. In this moment, we're using can for request, to make requests. Igual que el could, to ask for things. Okay? Do you understand, guys? Do you understand so far?
Peter.
Yes, Galileo.
No question.
Okay.
So can
I can
we can
Galileo.
Use can
uh-huh.
I, yes. Can you hear me, teacher?
Yes, I can hear you well. Yes,
here I am. Here I am.
He's a ghost today. Okay.
we can use can como habilidad, como permiso, sí. Y como request. Three, sí. Three ways.
That's right. Yes, Galileo.
Okay.
Okay. Va a depender, okay, el significado que usted le dé va a depender del contexto. Si yo estamos platicando y le digo, usted me pregunta, Jessica, ¿puede nadar? Y yo le mentiría y le voy a decir que sí. Yes, I can swim, all right? Entonces, ahí hablamos de habilidad, de algo que yo puedo realizar o soy capaz de hacer. Ability.
Puedo hacer.
All right? Sí. Okay. Dice, teacher, ¿puedo tener sí. mi cámara apagada? Un segundo. Can I turn off my camera, please? Is you're like asking for permission. Yo le puedo decir, yes, you can, or no, you can't. All right?
Sí.
And in this, today, in this context, we're using can for request. Can you help me? All right, no le estoy pidiendo permiso, no le estoy pidiendo si puede hacer, tiene habilidad de algo, sino que estoy haciendo una solicitud que por favor me ayude. Can you help me, please? Entonces usamos can for request. All right.
Thank you.
Very good. Thank you. A ver, someone else had another question. Hi, Anita. Someone else had another question. No more questions? No? No porque entendemos o no porque el hamster no está corriendo muy rápido. All right.
Nos ha ido el inter, teacher.
Ah, no, William, mentira.
Es que muy elegante vino hoy.
Bueno. All right.
A mí se me ha ido el hamster.
A usted se le ha ido la luz, Galileo. No, I'm kidding. All right, very good. Any other question, guys? No?
Sure, but no. If I need help, what is the question?
The question would be, Luis Manuel, can you help me? Okay. Or you can also,
I am listening.
Yes, or you can also say, could you help me? It depends if you know the person or not, Luis. All right?
But we can use two phones.
Yes, you can, yeah. Mm-hmm. Okay. Yes, you can. All right, depending on the situation, depending on who you're talking to. Okay? But yeah,
okay,
you can
thank
say,
you.
Like, yeah, very good. Thank you.
Hello?
Hola. Oh, I'm sorry, Beatriz. All right.
How are you?
Luis Alfonso. Okay, very good. Luis, do you understand Luis Alfonso? Everything okay? Yes?
Everybody, teacher.
Okay.
Teacher, thank you.
You understand? Okay, very good. A ver, entonces, todos ahorita pensando en can for request. All right. One question for can, using can. For request, all right? Okay, let's do it right now. One question, make a question using can to request something. Okay.
Can you go to a meeting, teachers? Es correcto.
Can you go to a meeting? Yes. Yep, very good.
Thank you.
Eli no le agrada entrar, ¿verdad? Que dice que sigue teniendo problemas.
Sí, mandó una captura que como le aparecía ahí, pero bien raro.
Mm-hmm. All right, let me know when you finish, guys, so we can start checking the sentences, please.
Yes, teacher.
Everybody finished, yes?
Only one sentence.
Si usted quiere hacer más, haga cinco, Luis Alfonso, pero ahorita only one.
I can.
Oh, come on, yes, you can. No encuentro a Eli. ¿Qué le pasó a Eli? All right, a ver. Okay, finish, guys.
Finish, teacher.
Okay, yes, let's teacher. See. All right. Permítame que le estamos escribiendo a Eli para que pueda entrar. All right, very good. Let's see. Uh-huh. William Mauricio, tell me your question, please. Tell me your request.
Can you check my report?
Oh, very good. Yes, very good question. Yes, I can, of course. Gonzalo, tell me your request, please. Gonzalo.
Can I go out with you next weekend?
Sure, yeah, you're not asking. Okay, very good. Gonzalo, of course, let's go. All right, very nice. Carlos, let's go.
Just joking, right?
Very good. Carlos Antonio, one request, please.
Can you repeat that, please?
Yes, of course. Yes, I can. My pleasure, Carlos. Very good. Edwin Valmore, your question.
Can you play football?
Ah, pero esa es habilidad, Edwin. ¿Verdad? Esa sería. La pregunta está bien hecha, Edwin, pero ya me cuestiona a mí sobre mi habilidad de poder jugar fútbol y no puedo. All right, no, I can't. All right. Okay, so let's think of another one, Edwin. Pensemos en otra, okay? Very good. Alex,
okay,
okay, le voy a dar un ratito para que la rephrase it y luego
me tengo otra.
Ah, okay, dígame.
Can you say hello in other language?
Pero siempre sigue siendo habilidad.
Igual.
Que puedo ser capaz o no de decir konnichiwa. All right, for example, okay. Mm-hmm. Ambas son de habilidad. Están bien hechas, Edwin, pero el contexto o el uso en ese caso es for ability. Okay. All right. Pensemos en otra, Edwin. La vamos a dejar de tarea y vamos a regresar donde usted otra vez. Alex, ask me one question, please.
Can you go to the beach with me?
When? Tomorrow? All right, very good. Edwin, yo creo, no sé si es su micrófono, Edwin. Please, please. No, no es el micrófono de Edwin. Or maybe no. Yes.
Right yeah, now, teacher.
Right now.
Right now, go.
Oh,
yeah.
My goodness. Too dark. All right, very good. Carlita, can you ask a request, please? Or can you make a request?
Can you please help me move the table?
Excellent. Yes, I can help you move the table. Luis Alfonso.
Me corrige, por favor.
Of course.
Can you tell me how to go to the mall? Pero usted estaba diciendo que es como una habilidad el decirle. Por eso le digo, can you tell me? Uh-huh. Can you tell me how to go to the mall?
No, pero esa no es habilidad, porque yo le puedo, me está como solicitando ayuda para decirle dónde está el shopping mall.
Correcto.
Yeah, it's okay. No, it's okay. Yeah. It's a request because you're, yeah, very good, Luis. Very nice. Thank you.
Una carita alegre. Una carita alegre.
Ya le voy a poner una. No se preocupe, ya la busco.
Thank you.
All right, let's see. Galileo. Galileo, my friend Galileo,
yes,
where are you? Uh-huh.
Yes. Can they come to the meeting next Friday morning?
Yeah, very good. Yes, can they come to the meeting next Friday morning? Luis?
Good job.
All right, Luis. Thank you, Luis.
Thank you,
Very good.
Ya,
okay.
Ya para finalizar estamos.
Sí, ya le hacía falta, ¿verdad? Perdóneme que no se los había, no les había dado happy faces. All right, si estuviéramos presencial le diera un sticker en su cuaderno, no se preocupe. A ver, Elmer Ramírez, tell me the question, the request. Make a request.
Can I work to my test, to the test. Can I work in my desk or PC to the test?
Can I work in my can I work in my computer, like the test, you mean?
Yeah.
Okay, that's a request. You're requesting for you to work on your computer, like the test on your computer. That's okay, yeah. Okay, that's fine, Elmer, very good. Dinora?
Can you go to the cinema with me?
Okay. Yeah, you're requesting for me to go with you. All right, very good. Thank you. Yes, I would love to. Jose Eduardo, what about your question?
Teacher, no sé si está bien. Can
Hola,
I you,
no te preocupe.
Can I you drive a car?
Ah, pero ese es de habilidad, Jose Eduardo. Can you drive a car? Es de habilidad, yo puedo o no puedo manejar, eso es de habilidad, está bien hecha, can you drive a car, pero no está requiriendo nada, sino que me pregunta si puedo o no manejar, all right, okay, similar to Edwin, that's okay, don't worry about it. Bea, can you make
sure.
That request, yes, Luis Manuel.
I have a question, if I say, can you help me to cook?
Yes.
It's okay.
Yeah, you're requesting. Yes. Because
okay,
you're requesting me to help you. You're not asking me if I can cook. You're asking me if I can help you. So that is a request. Yes, very good.
Okay, all okay. Right.
Yes, I would love to help you cook. Very good. Thank
and
you.
And I don't like.
Oh, come on.
No.
Okay.
And I cannot
teach you.
Oh, okay. All right. Yes, Galileo.
The correct pronunciation is can or can.
Depends how you see it.
The
I usually say can. All right, it's not like
can,
an
like e.
More like that. British people, they pronounce it more like can. Can you help me? It's like an kind of thing. All right.
Both way are
closed. Yeah, yeah. It's like potato, potato, 2020. It's okay.
Okay.
All right. Thank you. Very good. Yeah, very good. Let's see. Bea, your request, please. Beta? Okay, maybe she's not around. Judith. Judith, ¿sabe qué? Ahorita que la vi, dije, ¿quién es? Hasta que leí el nombre, porque como siempre está in a living room, I'm like, who is she? All right, that's okay, Judith. Very good.
I'm in the same place, but I'm not in the desk.
Oh, all right. Okay, very good. So I'm like, I was wondering, who is this beautiful lady?
Nos la cambiaron.
Uh-huh. That's not Judith. No, I'm kidding. All right, Judith, can you ask a request, please? Can you make a request?
Bueno, se me olvidó, la tenía ahorita.
Oh, no.
Can you... Sí, que le iba a preguntar. Give me a second.
Okay.
Oh. Can you let me your notebook?
But that's more like a permission.
¿Sería let me or borrow?
Can you borrow?
Borrow. Okay.
Yeah, all right. Okay, you're asking, you're requesting me to borrow my book. Yeah, it's okay. Very good. Thank you. Let's see. Olga, what about your request? Thank you, Judith.
Can you go to downtown?
Okay. All right. So you're requesting for me to go with you. Very good. Ana Solis? All right, maybe not. Okay, very good. Carlos Alfredo, can you make a request?
Can you cook my dinner, please?
No. All right, let's go in pupusas. That's better. That's faster. All right, yeah, you're requesting okay. If I can do it. All right, very good. Nice. Let me see. Luis Manuel ya me dijo la suya, ¿verdad? Like, can you help me cook? ¿O esa era otra?
Yes, teacher.
All right. Okay. That's okay. Very good. Beita, are you back? No? Okay. That's okay. All right, guys. Very good. Entonces, vamos a regresar a Edwin. Where's Edwin? Edwin? Se me fue Edwin. No puede ser. Oh, José Eduardo, ¿arregló la suya?
No, teacher, todavía no.
Ah, oh, José Eduardo, all right. Le voy a volver a preguntar en unos 10 minutos. Oye, no se preocupe.
Okay, teacher.
All right, very good. Okay, entonces, remember, guys, please. Una cosa es can for ability, can for permission, and can for request. We're using can right now for request, to make requests, okay? So you're asking something, all right? If someone can help you, if someone can borrow, if someone can do it something for you, all right? Or go with you somewhere, okay? So you are requesting something, okay? Let's see. Let's go back to the book here, all right? So we have the book, okay? So here we have how to use can for informal request, okay? Aquí está la palabra clave. It's informal. No es pesado, no es que sea maleducada, solo que es informal, all right? So what is the structure? All right, so here we have these ones. Can plus subject plus verb base form plus complement plus question mark. Volvemos a hacer nada más preguntas porque estamos requiriendo algo. Usted está preguntando, solicitando algo de otra persona. That's why it's a question, okay? So, if you notice, example number one says, can you is the subject, right is the verb, all right? On the like base form, this please, all right? That is the complement, okay? Let's see, and here we have, can you help deliver these letters today, please? All right, again, can, a ver. All right, can you is the subject, help is the verb, deliver, these letters today, that would be the rest of the complement, okay? Igual que en los otros casos, con el could or would like to, el verbo no sufre cambio porque seguimos con los verbos modales. Quiere decir que en este curso ustedes han visto tres verbos modales o una expresión modal que sería would like to, could, and can. Three modal verbs. Y las reglas aplican igual porque son dentro de la familia de los verbos modales o expresiones modales. Lleva would, lleva could y lleva can. Cuidado con la pronunciación de would. No me vaya a decir would o could. No hay L ahí. En la escritura sí, en la pronunciación no. Could, would, all right? And then we have can, all right? Do you have any questions so far, guys? No questions?
No, no? Teacher.
Okay. Solo excellent, very good, guys. Thank you. A ver, solo déjenme aquí. Just give me a second, guys, please. Okay. All right, so here we have. Seguimos con la misma presentación que hemos estado on these days. All right, again, I'm going to put everybody silent again because we're watching the news. All right, so here we have. Esta es la que hemos venido usando the whole week, all right? But now, I just want you to see this. Hold on. Okay, so here we have. Ayer vimos could. Today we're studying can, all right? So it's the same thing, for request. Could is formal, can is informal, all right? So we saw this one. Now, the modal verb can, okay? This is the same structure, it's the same structure that is in the book. Can plus subject plus verb plus complement plus question mark, okay? Now, these are the responses, again. Esas respuestas nos pueden servir no solo para el could, also for can, all right? Here, si se fija, cuando usted dice que no, usted dice, I'm sorry. Por ejemplo, si usted me hubiera dicho, el caso de Luis Manuel, que me dijo, can you help me cook? All right, yo le podría decir, I'm sorry, I can't. No, you can't. Eso de yo no puedo, I can't. Si Luis Manuel viene y me dice, teacher, could you help me cook? Y le digo, I can't, se oye pesada la respuesta. ¿Ok? Entonces, hacemos la respuesta un poco más suave y le digo, I'm sorry, Luis Manuel, I can't. All right? No de un solo I can't, porque también es como, Luis Manuel se puede sentir así como, ok, all right, I'm not gonna help, I'm not gonna ask. O si ustedes hubieran preguntado, teacher, can you help me? Yo le digo, I can't. Entonces, it's not very nice. You have to say, I'm sorry, I can't. All right? Another way, si usted quiere dar una negativa, puede decir también, I'm afraid I can't. Me temo que no puedo. All right? I'm afraid I can't. No solo I can't. Okay? Yes? Do you guys understand that? ¿Mueve la cabecita así? Or thumbs up? Yes? Very good, William. Thank you. Thank you, Galileo. All right? Very good. Okay? Pero si usted puede hacer algo, usted me dice, sure. Can you help me cook? Sure. Yeah, sure, certainly, yes, of course. Usted puede decir, I would love to, me encantaría, all right? Also, as an answer, okay? So we can play, en este caso no solo vemos como, yes, I can't, no, I, yes, I can, no, I can't. We have these different responses, ¿por qué? Porque nos están solicitando ayuda. Entonces, podremos decir, claro, por supuesto, sí, lo siento, no puedo. Okay, o me temo que no puedo. Hi, Blanquita.
Sí pude.
Oh, no, si estaba preguntando así por primera vez, y va invicta.
La tuve que ir a traer.
Oh, no. Okay, thank Gracias, you. All right, very good. So here we have, igual acá, podemos aceptar that. I would be glad to, es como me encantaría. Esta contracción acá es would. I would be glad to, or I would like to, or I would love to. You can say that. Fine, no problem. Sorry, but All right. I would like to, but me gustaría, pero, y a usted da la excusa, ¿verdad? No tengo tiempo, estoy ocupada, tengo reunión, no sé, whatever the answer is. Okay? You guys understand that? Yes? Okay? Let's go on here. Okay. Permítame, solo quiero ver una cosa. A ver, a ver, a ver, a ver. Let me see, guys, here something. All right, can you please take a picture of this? I just want to see what time it is. Can you please take a picture right now? Finished? Yes?
Yes.
Take a picture of this.
Sorry. Please, sorry.
No, that's okay. Okay. Take a picture of this one too, guys. Okay.
Okay.
No, Carlita? Okay, and take a picture of this. Okay. Okay, esta no, todavía no. Okay, so ¿qué van a hacer? Van a terminar, van a llenar los espacios que faltan usando can. All right. All right, usando can or can't en la respuesta, o yes, or sure, no problem, o como le podamos contestarle aquí. Estas de acá solo hay imágenes. Necesito que ustedes hagan la pregunta y la van a hacer de dos formas, la formal y la informal. ¿Ok? Quiere decir que una va a ser could y la otra va a ser can. All right, and then you complete the request. You complete the question. Lo mismo con esta. ¿Ok? Yes, guys? Hello?
Yes.
All right. Okay.
Yes.
Okay. ¿Qué micrófono está abierto? Que oigo tele. All right. Very good. Okay. Let's see. Let's...
¿Me puede poner la primera pantalla? Que me salió una foto.
¿Ahorita? Sí, no se preocupe. This one, Blanca.
Yes. Yeah?
Yeah. Okay, sí. Very good. Thank you. All right, so let's go to the groups right now, guys. Please, working on those images. Dinora, hi Gonzalo,
him your computer? Es así, puedes prestarle a él tu computador. Es algo así como un request, pero más como educado, como dice la teacher, y con menos confianza.
Sí, sí,
o sea, si tenemos confianza, yo te diría, hey, prestar la computadora, punto.
Bueno, que al final la del dinero podría haber sido cool también. Ajá, no ¿también? Necesariamente can. O sea,
así es.
Ajá, sí, como decís, depende del contexto en el que estás o la persona con la que estés tratando.
Sí, porque puedo estar usando can con un amigo o con un desconocido. O correcto. Puede ser amigo, pero me da pena y se lo digo así como más suave. Ajá.
Uh-huh. Okay. Con you borrow.
Could. Acuérdate que es como C-U-D, así se pronuncia. Could. Could. No es could, sino que could. Como que pusieran la C, la U y la D. Could. Could you borrow him your computer? ¿Puedes prestarle a él tu computador? Es un request, ¿verdad? ¿Qué pasó en todo esta cosa? Carlos.
Ok. No, en esa no te escuché. En la última.
Decía que cool, no es cool ni cool, sino que es como que escribiera C-U-D, good.
Good.
Could you borrow him your computer? Vaya, number two, digamos, lend me a hand, dame una mano, ahí es como, lend también es prestar, teacher. Hi, teacher.
Es similar.
¿Me escuchas? ¿O será que está fallando mi?
Sí, escucho. Teacher, ¿cuál es la diferencia en lend y en borrow? Si ambos son como prestar. ¿Cuándo se utiliza
lend? Cuando usted realiza la acción, es el primero que me dijo.
¿De borrow es por dinero?
No. Cuando usted realiza la acción. Usted me pide prestado, entonces uso esa primera palabra que usted me acaba de decir. Y si yo le presto, entonces es lend.
Ah, entonces.
Cuando yo solicito que me presten algo,
ajá, es lend. No, al revés.
Cuando yo presto algo, es lend.
Sí, ajá.
Es que nuestra oración está así. Can you borrow me $10?
Uh-huh.
Can you borrow me $10? Eso uh-huh. está bien. Yo le estoy diciendo a usted que me preste $10.
Uh-huh.
Ok. Entonces, en el caso de lend, en sentido...
Es que usted le va a dar el dinero a él.
En el caso de lend.
Ajá. Uh-huh.
Can I lend you some money? Eso estaría bien.
Pero usted se lo está ofreciendo.
Ajá.
Entonces, no, lo tenía. O sea, sería así, permítame, ahorita.
El caso del dinero, para entenderlo un poco más.
Así sería, ahí está. Uy, se los puse a todos, pero no importa.
Can you borrow $10?
Ajá.
$10.
Ajá. Algo así lo tenemos. ¿Usted le diría
esto? Lend? En caso de lend, es ya donde nos confundimos un poco.
Es cuando usted se lo va a dar. ¿Ya?
Entendimos que tenían que hacer preguntas.
Sí, por sí, eso sí. Es que... Ajá, por eso la primera, can you?
Ajá.
Ajá.
Ok.
All right.
Pero en este caso, todos tienen que ser preguntas, ¿verdad?
Sí, sí, sí. Ajá, usando el could y usando el can. Right? Okay. Okay.
Yeah. Okay.
Can you borrow me money? Me puede prestar dinero. Ah, no, pero aquí no, no sería el mío. Pues no, así está bien. Y la otra, can you...
Hello, William. Hello, Edwin.
Hello, teacher.
¿Cómo vamos?
So-so.
¿Por qué, William? Why? What happened?
Teacher, hemos escrito acá en el staff borrow, open, lend, y print. Hemos escrito, can you borrow the money?
Mm-hmm.
Can you open the door?
Okay.
Can you let me the pencil?
Okay.
Okay.
La otra.
Bring extra, bring extraer, ¿verdad?
Mande.
Bring extraer.
Sí, 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 sí.
¿Cómo se pronuncia?
Bring, no así como lo pronuncia usted.
Okay. Can you bring?
Can you bring me glass with water?
Yeah, very good. Yes. Yeah, very good. ¿Se le fue la luz, Edwin, un ratito?
Sí, se fue la energía un rato.
Y de repente así como, Edwin, deme la otra oración. Y ya no estaba. Lo salvó la luz.
Sí, pero ya la tenía lista.
¿En serio? A ver, dígamela.
Sí. Y es una similar a la que acabamos de encontrar. La de,
ajá. Ah, can ok.
You, can you get me pen?
Ok.
Please.
Yeah. Yes, ajá.
Esa es la que tenía.
Requesting. You're requesting, ajá, something.
¿Cómo dijiste, Luis? Can you bring?
Can you bring me glass with water?
Glass.
Yeah.
De vaso.
With water.
Yeah. So with did water. You finish all of the pictures, Edwin and William?
Nos faltan 3, 4.
Ah, okay. All right. That's okay. That's okay. We have like 2 more minutes. Okay.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you. Hi, Luis Manuel. Hi, Bea. Finished?
Yes, teacher.
All right. Yes. Yeah, all right, very good. So we're going to go back and we're going to check the sentences or the questions, okay?
Okay.
All right. All right, guys, very good. We're going to take attendance right now y luego seguimos revisando las oraciones. A ver, Alex Humberto Saldaña Rodríguez.
Present, teacher.
Ana Beatriz Pineda Olmedo.
Present.
Ana Judith Portillo Bautista. All right, Blanca Elizabeth Alvarenga Mejía.
Present.
All right, Carlos Alfredo Portillo Núñez.
Present.
Thank you. Carlos Antonio Escobar Hernández.
Present.
Dinora Alejandra Alfaro Corea.
Present, teacher.
Edwin Valmore Flores Gómez.
Present.
Elmer Ubaldo Ramírez Cruz.
Present.
Francisca Elizabeth Martínez Gámez. Gonzalo Valle Valle.
I'm here, teacher.
Thank you. José Eduardo Guzmán Álvarez.
Present, teacher.
José Galileo. Ah, José no lo había quitado el chequecito. José Galileo Barrera Hernández.
Present, teacher.
All right, very good. Let's see. Carla Marisol Escobar Arbaiza.
Present.
Luis Alfonso Martínez Pérez.
Present.
Luis Manuel Muñoz Acevedo.
Present, teacher.
Norma Lizeth Quintana Mancía. Olga Marina Contreras Acosta.
Present.
All right, William Mauricio González García.
I'm here.
Yolanda Melanie Pérez Enríquez. Ada Karina Cruz García. Ana Solís, Ana Karin Solís López.
Present, teacher.
Thank you, Anita. Very good. Okay, guys. So I'm going to show you this. Okay. So let's, we can share it and we can check the answers. Let's see. Number 1A. Uh-huh. Olga, ¿qué tiene para la número A?
Good to like to. Good to like to come with us.
Yes. Otra vez, Olguita, espéreme, espéreme. Olguita, Olguita, regáleme otra vez la 1A.
Good.
Ajá.
Tom like to.
Ah, okay. Would Tom like to come with us? Eso puso ustedes. Okay, eso pusieron ustedes. Okay. Okay.
Yes.
Y la respuesta es
yes. Yes, would.
Yes, he would like to. ¿Verdad? Si ustedes usaron
yes, he would.
Ajá.
Yes, he would like
to.
Teacher, no sería.
Ok. Ya, yeah, okay. A ver, en la forma que Olga la hizo es: Would Tom like to come with us? Yes, he would like to. Podría ser una opción. A ver, William.
Can Tom come with us?
A ver, can Tom come with us? All right. Yes, he
can with us.
Yes, he can come with us. Us, all right. A ver, ¿alguien más tiene diferente esa?
Teacher, mi, quiero ver qué la hice. Ay, ¿qué se me hizo? Yo le había puesto con Utah, come with you. Yes, he can.
Dígamelo otra vez, Carlita, disculpe.
Could you talk on with you use yes he can
usando el could Carla
yes
could Tom come with us yes he
can
could si va a usar could en la pregunta es could en la respuesta
okay
all right
okay.
Very good that's okay all right anybody else no.
We put could instead of can.
Could Tom?
Could Tom okay. Come
yeah.
With
all
us.
Right, that's fine. Okay. What about 2A, guys? Can I help you? Yes? Uh-huh. Galileo, what do you have for that one, Galileo?
Teacher, we have a doubt about this expression.
Uh-huh.
Can I help you?
Sí.
But if I say yes, I can.
Uh-huh.
Pero dice, say, can I help you? Uh-huh. The other people must say, yes, you can. But this say, yes, I can again.
Ajá, lo que pasa es que no debe de llevar el can ahí, Galileo. Es como cuando usted dice sí, y luego da, o sea, el sí es para can I help you, all right? And then okay. You continue giving more information, Galileo.
Yes, it's a really short answer.
Yeah, very short answer, yeah. Which is okay because you continue giving more information there.
Okay, can I help you? Yes, I buy a ticket to Melbourne. Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
I can buy a ticket. Okay, very good. Yes, uh-huh.
Teacher, no se puede. Yes, I would like to a ticket.
I would like to buy a ticket.
Oh.
That could be another choice. Yes, I would like to buy a ticket to Melbourne. All right. That could be another choice also, Galileo. Yes, I would like to buy a ticket to Melbourne. Okay.
Okay.
All right, very good. What about 3, guys? What do you have for 3? Luis Alfonso?
No, teacher. No, I understand. Sorry.
No, why not, Luisito? What happened? Okay,
sorry, teacher. Sorry.
Hagámoslo juntos, ese ejercicio. A ver, ¿qué pasó?
Okay.
Would you like to work on Saturday?
Sure. Podría ser, yeah. Would you like to work on Saturday? And you say no.
I know work.
Okay, you can say no, I wouldn't.
I wouldn't like to.
No, I wouldn't like to. All right, that could be a choice, Luis. Very good. Okay, that's another choice. What about four, guys? 4A? ¿Quién tiene esa 4A?
Can you see her?
Would you like to see a movie?
Uh-huh.
No, I wouldn't.
No, I'm like. Sorry. No, I wouldn't like to. All right. So all those ways to answer or to respond. All right. And number five, what?
Chair, a question.
Yes, Alex.
I write a number 4, 8.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Can you see movie? Yes, of course. It's okay.
All right. Can you see a movie? All right. Could you see a movie? Mm-hmm. All right. Yeah, it's okay also. All right. Okay. No, I wouldn't. Or no, I can't. Okay, very good. And what about five, guys? The last one.
What can you do tomorrow?
What can you do tomorrow? Sure, another possibility. Any other possibility for number five? What?
What could you do tomorrow?
What would you like to do tomorrow? What would you like to do tomorrow? Okay. Okay. Let's see this one, guys. Let's check this one here. All right. We have borrow. Okay. So let me hear the choices, guys, with borrow. Uh-huh.
Can you borrow some money?
Can you borrow some money? All right. What about open?
Can you open the door?
Can you open the door? All right. Ese sería informal. ¿Y la más formal?
Could you open the door?
Please? Could you open the door? Very good. What about lend?
For me, please.
Yeah, that's even better. What about lend?
Can you lend me pen?
Can you lend me a pen? All right. Can you lend? I can. Oh, yeah. Can you lend me a pen? Very good. What about bring?
Can you bring me a glass of water?
Yeah. All right. In the case of can or could be Edwin, could.
Can you bring me glass with water?
Y lo hacemos un poco más formal, Edwin. En lugar del can, podemos usar cuál.
Would you bring me?
Yeah. Could you bring me glass a with water. Could you bring a glass of water, please? Or just like that. Very good. What about turn off? Let me see here. Alex, what do you have for turn off? Alex, your mic is off.
Sorry. Can you turn off the TV, please?
Yes, very good. Okay, Luis, Alfonso, with could, ¿cómo quedo con could? Luis Alfonso.
No, understand, teacher. Sorry.
¿Qué le pasó, Luis? Solo porque viernes.
My mind is in other.
Your mind is in United States.
Yes, teacher. Tomorrow I travel.
Ah, all right. Eli, hi, Eli. No la había visto entrar, Eli. Very good. Thank you, Eli, for being in class. All right. Okay, let's see. Luis Manuel, what about a turn off with could?
Can you turn off the TV?
Okay, and with could, Luis Manuel, ¿cómo lo haríamos? Could?
Could you turn off the TV?
Excellent. Yes, very good. All right. Let me see. Elmer, what about tell? Elmer? Elmer, can you hear me, Elmer?
Yeah, teacher. Could you tell me where the train station?
Excellent. Could you tell me where the train station is? ¿Y si lo hacemos con Ken? Carla, ¿cómo nos queda? Thank you, Elmer.
No, teacher, esa no la hice porque no la entendí la figura.
Ah, es que es un tren y hay una estación. Ajá.
No, no la hice, mejor hice el del gatito.
Ah, ok, all right. So, en el caso de Ken, ¿cómo nos quedaría el del tren? Anybody else? Ajá.
We wrote.
Ok, Benita, and then William. Ajá, vea.
We wrote... Can you tell me when the train arrives?
Ah, very good. Can you tell me when the train arrives? Very good. Okay, that's perfect. What about William?
Can you tell me train station?
Can you tell me where the train station is?
Okay.
All right, very good. What about feed? Dinora, what do you have for feed? Dinora? All right, no, Dinora. Carlos Antonio, what do you have for feed?
Can you feed my cat?
Excellent, can you feed my cat? Very good. Or with could? Anybody else with could?
Could you feed him pets?
Could you feed his pet? Could you feed his pet? Very good, Carlos. Excellent. Very nice. Thank you. All right. Very good. Okay. Let's see. Vamos a regresar al manual un ratito aquí. Y luego seguimos con lo demás. Okay. Oh, we finished. Very good. Pretty much. Okay. So here we have. Here we're going to make 5 questions, okay? It says write 5 requests that your boss could ask you next week. Quiero que piensen su jefe, su supervisor, el gerente, quien sea, all right, de su trabajo, and write 5 requests, okay, that your boss could ask you, all right? No es que usted le pida a su jefe pidiéndole a usted, all right? Like to do in your office. 5. Okay, let's do that right now. Lo vamos a hacer aquí. 5 requests that your boss could ask you next week. Ahora, usted conoce mejor su jefe que obviamente yo. Entonces, ¿cómo le pediría algo a su jefe? ¿Usando could o usando can? No sé. All right, usted decide. Usted lo conoce mejor. Usted dice, ah, sí, él me diría could. O no, ella me diría can. All right, so do that right now. 5. Todas relacionadas. Excuse me, William.
My jefe no usa could.
Only can.
Only can.
Only do it. An imperative, William.
Right now.
Oh, no, like an imperative. All right, bueno, entonces usted piense, all right? Could or can. O puede ser unas 3 con can y otras 2 with could, okay?
Okay.
All right. Empezamos a hacerlas. Me van avisando when you guys are finishing, please.
mañana fueron maravillosos los resultados que hiciste. Yo sé que te estarás preguntando, ¿y qué mezcla es esta? Porque yo mismo me hice la misma pregunta, ya que la decisión de la que la querrás hacerse inmediato. Ya verás por qué. También, como diga lo extra, este video
if I want to write down about la limpieza en un parqueo, can I say look the clean on the parking lot?
I'm not sure I'm understanding, Galileo.
Okay, si yo tengo que supervisar la limpieza en el parqueo,
ajá,
¿puedo usar la palabra clean como sinónimo de limpieza, ajá, o hay otra específica?
Tell me in English.
Okay, and my five my five sentences, my five question is, can you take a look the clean on the parking lot? Maybe my boss can can say me that.
All right. But
I'm sure if say take a look the clean is the
correct. No. Clean is only a verb actually. You could say, could you supervise how clean the parking lot is? But it's a little bit long, all right? Could you check on the cleaning of the parking lot? Cleaning could be better.
Okay.
Okay.
Thank you.
Yep, very good. You finished, Galileo?
Yeah.
All right, William finished, Carlos Antonio finished?
Yes, teacher.
Excellent. Elmer, Alex, Edwin finished? Yes.
So.
Okay. Elmer and Edwin, yes. Luis Alfonso, Luis Manuel, Jose Eduardo, finished.
Yes, teacher.
Excellent. All right, voy a empezar con usted, Luis Alfonso. Olga Marina, Blanca, Carlita, Nora, Beatriz, finished. Luis Manuel, Ana.
Yes,
okay, teacher.
Excellent. Very good. All right. Thank you. Okay.
Yes, so,
thank you. All right, Luis Alfonso, tell me three, please. Luis Alfonso, su micrófono.
Sorry, teacher. Can you take to elaborate a check?
Again, Luis?
Can you take, no, can you to elaborate a check?
¿Sabe que acaba de tocar otra regla de los verbos modales, Luis?
El tú.
Exacto, no. Muy bien. En los verbos modales no ponemos el tú.
All right.
Can a you... menos que lo lleve, como would like to. Ese ya lo lleva, pero oh, can, could, no lo lleva, entonces no lo ponemos. Entonces sería...
Can you.
Can you.
Can you elaborate a check.
Excellent, Luis. Very yes, good. Thank you.
No, okay. Okay. Number two. Aquí la dice bien larga y no me voy a entender. No voy a entender mi inglés tan perfecto. Okay. Would you report the failure in the equipment of communication?
Yeah, it's okay. Perfect. Very good.
Number three.
Uh-huh.
Can you supervise the report this day?
The report.
The report.
Uh-huh. Very good. Lo demás está bien. Uh-huh.
Ya estuvieron las tres, le doy las cinco.
Sí, siga, siga. Es que le está buscando la happy face, ajá.
Me está buscando errores, pero no me va a hallar. Would you send this email for our supplier in Canada?
Excellent, Luis. Ya ve, no le encuentro ningún error. Very good, good. Ajá.
All right. In the finish, can you bring the report of the invoices of this week?
Wow, Luis, nice. Mires lo que se merece.
Wow, thank you, teacher. I'm very happy.
Very good, Luis. Very good. All right. Thank you, Luis Alfonso. William, three questions or three requests.
Okay, teacher. You have to grow these models for the next week.
Tell me again, William.
You have to grow this model for the next week. Así okay. Me diría, mi. Yo sé, le voy a decir la otra, pero. Dice, could you take time next week?
Okay, all right.
Could you call your people to meeting next week?
Okay, all right.
Y la otra dice, could you tell me with why your people don't believe?
Oh, okay.
Finish, teacher.
Okay, very good. Okay, William, la pronunciación es could.
Could.
Could, all right. Could. Así como K-U-D, así imagínesela, could, all right?
Okay. Sí, teacher, es que se me había ido el hunter.
Okay. All right, very good. Let's see. Blanca, tell me three requests, please, Blanquita.
Yeah, a veces están buenas.
Of course.
¿Cómo se dice? Actualizar.
Update. Uh-huh.
Production, please.
Ah, very good. Nice.
Could you go check the metrics? Machine is it working, please?
Okay, could you check the machine if it's working? Uh-huh.
Could you have me work on Sunday, please?
Okay. Uh-huh.
Extra.
Yeah, okay, very good, Blanca. Very good sentences, very good request. Ya ver, las tiene muy bien. A ver, Alex. Okay, Ana, Solís.
Hi, teacher.
Alex. Okay, Alex, tell me.
Okay, could you fix that for me?
Okay.
Could you liquidate the travel expenses from last week?
Okay. Uh-huh.
Could you come here, please?
Okay.
That's it, teacher.
Okay, very good.
Yeah. No. Wait.
Okay.
Could you wear the car to workshop, please?
Okay, very good. Yes, Alex, very nice. Thank you. Ana Solis, do you have your sentences?
Hola, teacher.
Hello.
Hola. ¿Me escucha?
Yes, loud and clear. Bye. Yes.
Okay. Bueno, yo más o menos lo entendí.
Ajá.
Los requisites, así se va, requisites.
Requisite, ajá.
Requisite. Sería, you can make delivery next week.
Okay.
Y puse también, you can supervise the following week.
Okay, okay.
El otro que puse fue, I'll call, give the report to Sofia another week.
Okay, so could,
Ajá. Podría, ¿verdad?
Yes.
Ajá, combinamos como puedo y como podré.
Yeah, of course, Ana, very good, yes.
Ajá, sería, we'll call you dancing the other with Wilbur.
Oh, okay. Okay.
Ay, la última me faltó, solo me quedé en podía, solo me quedé en call you give me a chance.
Mm-hmm.
Podría darme una oportunidad, quería poner.
Yeah,
aquí.
Could you give me a chance? Very good, Ana. That's a good one. Thank you. Very good, Anita. Let's see, okay, Carlos. Anita. Thank you, Ana. Carlos Antonio, your sentences, please. Your requests.
Would you write a letter of recommendation?
Oh my goodness, okay.
Could you tell me how to do it?
Yes. How to do it?
How to do it?
Yes, very good. Very good, Carlos. Very good.
Can you tell me the truth?
Ah, could you tell me the truth?
Yes.
Truth. Ajá, la verdad. All right. T-R-U-T-H. Truth. Ajá.
Yes.
Okay.
Can you give me a hand?
Okay, nice. Very good.
Ya, solo esas tengo, teacher.
Pero súper bien, súper nice. Thank you.
Thank you.
Very good. A ver, Carlitos. Ay, no, se apagó. Very good work today, Carlos.
Thank you.
And for everybody, of course. A ver, let me see. Olga. Olga.
Hi. Could you modify the report?
Could you modify? Ah, okay. All right.
Could you call the clients?
Okay.
Would you attend the supervisor?
Oh, okay. All right. Very good. Nice. Thank you. Let me see. Edwin, your questions or your requests?
Okay, teacher. Could you get me the date of yesterday?
Okay.
Could you let me binocle?
Can you?
Creo que sí se pronuncia bitácora.
Ajá, yes, okay.
Can you make the maintenance the equipment?
Excellent. Mm-hmm. That's it?
Can you write this report, the equipment?
Okay, the report. Okay, report. Very good. Yes, very nice. Jose Eduardo, your sentences, your request.
Okay, could you help me by checking the inventory?
Excellent, Jose Eduardo.
You can take...
Mm-hmm.
You can take
mm-hmm.
Days no sé cómo se dice days estos no sé
this
okay uh-huh. Uh-huh. You can say this report?
It's very good, yes.
Okay. Could you could you bring my yes. day food?
Oh, okay. Oh my goodness. Okay, the day, okay, your daily food. Very good. Excellent, José Eduardo. Very good. Ya ve, mire. La logra ver. No, no la ve.
Sí, teacher. Yeah, yes.
¿Y sabe qué dice? Ajá, se la, le voy a decir qué dice. Dice, you tried really hard. Intentó muy duro ahora. Muy buen, bien hecho. Excellent. Very good. Ya ve si puede. All right, Galileo, tell me your sentences.
Okay, okay, teacher. Number one, could you show me the stock inventory on Friday 9 a.m.?
Okay. Number Friday two, night a.m.? What do you mean?
I'm sorry?
Friday night? And then you say? Tell me again that sentence, please.
Okay. Could you show me the stock inventory on Friday at 9 a.m.?
Ah, okay. Yeah. Okay. 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 Me bad. Okay. Uh-huh. My bad.
Okay. Number two. Uh-huh. Can you tell me about two worm importation from Mexico? Worm, son horno, ¿verdad?
Oven.
Oven.
Yes.
Okay. Oven. Mm-hmm. Can you tell me about two oven importation from Mexico?
Ah, okay. All right.
Number three. Uh-huh. Can you go to warehouse to check the spare parts of divider? Spare parts are different pieces.
Pieces?
To fix the machine divider.
Oh, okay. Cool.
The divider is the machine we use to cut.
To cut. Uh-huh.
Cut the dough.
Oh.
In his different sizes.
Okay. Oh, cool. All right. Interesting. So
can you go to warehouse to check the spare parts of divider?
Okay.
Number four, could you come to my office to check cheese pizza price?
Oh, okay. All right.
Can you supervise the cleaning on the parking lot?
Mm-hmm.
That is number five.
Excellent. Very good. Thank you. Very good. Gonzalo, can you tell us your request, please?
Okay. Could you help me in this meeting, please?
Uh-huh.
Can I do a favor in your office this morning?
Okay.
Could you show me to use your computer, please?
Oh, okay. Interesting. Mm-hmm.
Can you start this meeting?
Okay.
Ah, se me trabó. Se me fue la piscucha. Could I send the paper for the invitation tomorrow?
Excellent. Afternoon? Very good, Gonzalo. Nice.
Okay, can you start your work tomorrow morning at 6 o'clock?
Excellent. Oh no. Okay. Very good. Thank you. All right, let's see. Alex, ya me dijo las suyas, Alex. Did you tell me your sentences?
Yes, teacher.
Oh yeah, yeah, I remember. Yes. Very good. Tell your sentences or your requests. No, Luis Manuel is not around. Okay, what about Dinora?
Yes.
Okay.
Could you write a letter, please?
Okay.
Could you read the email, please?
Okay.
And could you send me a report, please?
Okay. So those requests are from Galileo or a different boss.
Different.
Okay, very good. All right, let's see. Bea, what about your sentences or your requests?
Could you send me the report of the week, please?
Okay, yeah, okay.
Could you tell me the answer of the client complaint?
Oh, nice.
And could you send me a reunion request?
Okay.
Esa no estoy segura, si es así.
No, it's okay, it's fine. Yeah, very good, Bea. Thank you. All right, and the last one, Carlos Alfredo, can you tell us your request, please? Carlos Alfredo, not available?
Okay. Okay. Yes, sorry. All right.
No, that's okay.
Se ha congelado.
¿Quién, yo? Yo me congelé.
Frozen teacher.
¿Me? ¿A Frozen?
Okay.
Ajá, Carlos Alfredo.
Okay, can you move your car?
Okay, I need to park. Okay.
My parking.
Okay, I'm kidding. That's my parking spot. Ajá.
Hello.
Can you turn on the air conditioner?
Okay.
Can you send the weekly report?
Report. Okay, very good. Report. Okay, okay, nice. That's it.
And another, can you attend the meeting with the boss?
Okay, all right, very good. Thank you. And Judith, are you there, Judith, somewhere? Judith? I don't know, she's not around. Okay.
Hello.
Hi, oh, what happened?
No sé, tengo mala señal.
Okay, don't worry about it. Okay, Judith, so tell me your sentence.
Can you help me with my computer, please?
Okay. All right.
Can you give me, can you send me the account report?
Report? Please? Report? Uh-huh. Oh,
report.
Yeah, don't worry about it.
I don't know.
That's it?
That's it.
All right. Okay, that's fine. Thank you. All right, guys. Very good. Okay, I'm just going to stop sharing this. Okay. I'm just going to show you this for everyone. Okay, so here. Ese es para todos. Pónganle ese ahí para que diga start students. All right. All of you guys are the start students. You're very, very, very good. Everybody. Not only Luis, not only Carlos. Everybody. Gonzalo, Elmer, Bea, Carlos Alfredo, Luis Manuel. Everyone. Start students.
Only
okay?
For me, teacher.
No, I'm sorry, Luis Alfonso. That's not true. Not only for you. Okay. It's for everybody. All right. Very good. Okay. We have like 10 more minutes. Okay. And then I'm going to let you go. Solo William me va a acompañar ahora. 10 minutitos, William. Oye, no se me duerma.
Okay. Ya estoy dormido, teacher.
No, nada. Okay, a ver. I want to show you something here, guys. Hold on. Okay. Trabajemos en esto. No nos vamos a ir a ningún lado ahorita. A ver, trabajemos en estas que están acá. Picture. All right. Usamos ahorita could or can. Como usted guste. All right. Look at the picture. ¿Qué podríamos poner? Para cada imagen, number one says, could you please take me to the airport? Okay, so this guy is asking for a taxi. All right, what about number two, three, four, five, and six? Escríbalas en su cuaderno ahí. All right. A ver, Olga, usted me va a decir la número dos. José Eduardo, number three. Galileo, number four. Blanca, number five. No se le va a olvidar el número porque a mí se me olvidó. Gonzalo, number six, y luego hay más, no se preocupe. Obviamente, le acabo de decir a uno a cada compañero, pero los demás igual haciéndolo todos. All right, very good, guys. Let's try to do it now together. With who is gonna do number two?
Would you tell the Mr. White?
Excuse me, Olga?
Would you talk the Mr. White?
Okay. Okay, could you or could I? Could I talk to Mr. White or could you talk to Mr. White?
Could you talk?
Okay, okay, all right, that's okay, very good. Who's gonna do number three? ¿A quién le asigné la tres? I can't remember. No? José Eduardo, ¿no fue usted la tres?
Teacher, fíjese que se me fue, que me cayó el inter y me conecté del teléfono. Ah. Pero ya la hago.
Okay. Okay, no se preocupe. A ver, who has number three, guys?
Me, teacher.
Okay, thank you, Carlita.
Could you see the market information?
Could you? Oh, all right, very good. Thank you. All right, who wants to do number four then?
It's me, teacher.
Thank
could
you.
Could you tell me it near my ear?
Okay, yeah, could you tell me it is a
chambre.
Yeah, it's a gossip. Oh no. All right, very good. Thank you, Galileo. Very good. What about number five? ¿A quién le tocaba la número cinco?
Me.
Okay.
Could you finish revisar?
Could you finish checking?
Checking this report, yes. Please.
Oh, pobrecito. Look at his face, right? What about number six? Who's doing number six? ¿A quién le tiene la seis?
A Gonzalo Valle.
Ajá, Gonzalo, tell me your sentence, please.
Could you do a call for me, please?
Oh, okay, very good. Or could you take a message also? Excellent, thank you. Let's see. Then we have nine. Ah, no, eso ya está. All right. Las nueve, no. Nueve, diez. Siete, ocho, nueve, diez. Las cinco y las seis ya no. A ver, lo vamos a hacer ahorita. Bea, can you do number seven, Bea? Look at the picture.
Can you sell me a jar of the fabric?
Oh, okay. Very good. Yes, nice. Thank you. Carlos Antonio, number eight.
Can you tell, can you tell me the order?
Oh, excuse me, very good, yes, very nice, thank you. Okay, Judith, what about number nine, Judith?
Maybe, could you look for this information in your
excellent
computer, please?
Very good, yeah, very nice. Ah, and Ariana is gonna tell me number 10. All right. Let me see.
Number 10.
Number 10, Luis? Excellent, Luis Alfonso. Uh-huh.
Will you marry me?
Pero en la office no creo que le digan, will you marry me? All right. Pero sería, could you? All right, very good. Or another possibility, what would it be? Uh-huh. ¿Alguien más? ¿Otra opción for number 10?
Nice to meet you.
Maybe. Could you tell me your name?
Please? Could you tell me your name? Very good. Yes.
Could you take this case?
Sure. Oh, very good. Yes, I don't want it.
They look like a lawyer.
Lawyers? All right. Yeah, no kidding. All right. Very good, guys. Okay, guys. So I'm going to take the last attendance. Acuérdense que el lunes no tenemos clase, pero el martes sí. All right. Hubiéramos terminado hoy, pero lamentablemente yo tuve problema de internet el lunes. La vamos, tenemos que reponer martes. El martes vamos a hacer la encuesta. Por favor, no la haga antes. La vamos a hacer together a la hora. Creo que nos toca a las 9. Entonces, please, please, please. All right. Don't do it. Okay. Alex Humberto Saldaña Rodríguez.
Present, teacher.
Ana Beatriz Pineda Olmedo.
Present.
Ana Judith Portillo Bautista.
Present.
Blanca Elizabeth Alvarenga
present.
Mejía.
Present.
Carlos Alfredo Portillo Núñez.
Present.
Carlos Antonio Escobar Hernández.
Present.
Dinora Alejandra Alfaro Corea.
Present, teacher.
Edwin Valmore Flores Gómez.
Present.
All right. Elmer Ubaldo Ramírez Cruz.
Present.
Francisca Elizabeth Martínez Gámez. Gonzalo Valle Valle.
Present, teacher.
José Eduardo Guzmán Álvarez.
Present, present.
José Galileo Barrera Hernández.
Here I am.
Thank you. Carla Marisol Escobar Arbaiza and Company. Luis Alfonso Martínez Pérez.
Cori, presente.
Thank you. Luis Manuel Muñoz Acevedo.
Present, teacher.
Thank you, Luis. Norma Lizer Quintana Mancía. Olga Marina Contreras Acosta.
Present.
William Mauricio González García. William. Thank you, teacher. William. Yolanda Melanie Pérez Enríquez. Ada Karina Cruz García. Ana Karin Solís López.
Present, teacher.
Excellent. Okay, guys. Entonces, los dejo descansar, excepto William. Necesito que recordarles de las tareas y el examen para el fin de semana para que el martes vengamos y hagamos un repaso del módulo, ¿verdad? Ya tiene que terminar. Les cayó bien porque tienen el fin de semana para hacerlo, pero sí necesito que lo hagan y que estén al día con las tareas. Igual, se les aprecia un montón. Los veo luego. Los veo el martes. Cuídense mucho. Happy Mother's Day para las mamis. All right,
nice,
un abrazo.
To
yeah.
God bless you.
God bless you too. Thank you. All right, guys. Yes, thank you. All right, guys.
Happy Mother. Ciao.
Bye-bye. Thank you. Bye.
Good night, teacher.
Bye. Good night.
See you Tuesday, teacher.
See you Tuesday, William. Thank you. Ah, no, you can't. William, you're tricking me. Qué bárbaro, William. No sé.
Sorry.
All right. Sí, cabal. Galileo, have a great weekend, Galileo. Anita, bye.
Bye, teacher.
Bye, Anita. Have a nice weekend. All right. William.
Hello, teacher.
¿Cómo le va? ¿Ah?
Bien, con sueño, cansado.
I know, William. William, where do you work?
In American Park.
Oh, really? Yes. So, William, you don't live in San Salvador?
No, I live in Santa Ana.
Oh, my goodness. Mire, casi que el último día me vengo a dar cuenta de que no es en San Salvador. Oh, really, William?
And you, teacher?
I live here in San Salvador. Yes. All right, very good. Ah, American Park. Yo tengo una exalumna que trabaja ahí.
Really?
Yes. She's a very good student. Yeah. Very good, William. Okay, William, so cuénteme, ¿qué le podemos ayudar? ¿Hay algo que le cuesta, que le da así que no lo entiende? ¿O algo que siempre he querido como descubrir la verdad en inglés or something? ¿Or anything that I can help you with?
Me cuesta dar una respuesta en inglés.
Okay.
Porque no es que en sí entienda todo lo que usted me dice, pero logro conectar las frases y al fin concreto lo que usted me quiere dar a entender.
Claro.
Pero para contestarle ya no encuentro las palabras. Okay. Y a veces encuentro los significados y todo eso.
Sí. Okay. William, la verdad que el expresar las ideas es lo más difícil, ¿verdad? Entonces es un proceso que nos toma tiempo porque primero lo entendemos y por último logramos exteriorizar lo que queremos decir. Entonces eso nos pasa a todos, ¿verdad? Entonces no se sienta así como, no sé cómo decirlo porque es lo más difícil. Ahora, ¿cómo se logra, William? Se logra practicándolo, equivocándonos, diciéndolo una y otra vez. Eso, ¿verdad? Tratando de entender cómo voy a contestar en presente simple. ¿Me escucha, William?
Sí, sí.
Okay. ¿Cómo voy a, lo que es presente simple, las respuestas que van dentro del presente simple? Por eso es importante ir entendiendo cada tiempo, porque en cada tiempo hay una forma de contestar.
Es correcto.
Entonces, una vez usted vaya viendo más tiempos, se va a dar cuenta cómo se contesta, por ejemplo, en pasado, cómo se contesta en presente simple, cómo se contesta en presente continuo, ¿verdad? Para que vayamos como poniéndole como por bloques, ¿verdad? Cada forma de expresar una idea. Y luego, pues nada, William, practicarlo porque es la única forma, ¿verdad? Como todo, aprendemos todo, ¿verdad? Es like practice, practice, practice. Pero sí, acuérdese que cuando nosotros nacimos, nos tardamos 2 años en poder decir una frase y todavía maldicha, ¿verdad? Y cuando los bebés, ¿verdad? Así es que, obviamente, ahorita estamos bebés otra vez aprendiendo a hablar. ¿Verdad? Y poco a poco vamos. Ahora, es importante que usted también pueda leer un poco en inglés, escuchar música en inglés, las películas en inglés, para que su oído siga trabajando, ¿verdad? Y aunque pareciera que no, usted va asimilando varias palabras. Es lo que usted me dice. Tal vez no entiende todo lo que yo le digo, pero identifica palabras y conecta.
Ajá.
Entonces, eso es muy bueno. ¿Y cómo va a tener más vocabulario? Exponiéndose a más vocabulario, con lectura, con canciones, con películas, con los maestros, con las tareas.
Sí, es correcto. Y quizá eso es lo que me ha estado fallando, de como en el trabajo, cero English.
Ya
vengo noche, solo vengo a estudiar. ya no me queda chance de practicar. Y música casi que no me queda tiempo. Me trabajo, mentira, no. Sí. No sé.
Sí, yo no, y lo entiendo. ¿Y trabajas sábados y domingos, William, o solo de lunes a viernes?
Estábamos trabajando lunes a viernes. Pero, bueno, ese, quiero ver, 2 días tengo, ya nos cambiaron a un turno 4x4. Ya me va a quedar más tiempo para estudiar porque voy a tener 4 días de descanso.
Ah, ok. ¿Y los otros 4 días va a ir, o sea, las mismas horas o cómo?
No, el proceso es de salgo más tarde. Tengo que entrar a las 6 y salir a las 6.
Sí, es bien largo. Entonces, el día.
Sí, por ejemplo, mañana me toca entrar a las 6. Este fin de semana me toca estar adentro.
Ah, ok.
Ajá, descanso de lunes, de martes, bueno, lunes porque es a suerte.
Sí.
De martes a jueves. Uh-huh. Entro viernes de nuevo.
Okay. Ah, okay. Uh-huh. All right. And your wife, William, she works with you in the same place.
My wife is employees.
Okay. In the same company?
No. It's in Yasaki.
Okay.
Uh-huh. It's right. Company different.
Yeah, it's a different company. All right. Yeah. Yeah, very good. And William, what do you do in your company?
I am a coach. I am a coach.
You're a coach. Ah, okay. All right. Yeah. Very good. And you guys make shirts? What do you make?
Es un uniforme, pregunta.
No, ¿qué hacen? ¿Qué confeccionan?
Camisetas. Okay. T-shirts.
Uh-huh.
Ah. T-shirts, pants. Y only
that? Okay. Uh-huh. How long have you been working in the company, William?
Hello?
Yes, that's okay. How long have you worked in American Park?
Yes, it's no sé cómo decir. Que es este. Que es bastante grande, me preguntan.
No, que cuánto tiempo lleva ahí.
Ah, 3 años. Three years.
Okay. Do you like it?
¿Cómo?
Do you like it?
Do you like
your job?
I like No set.
That's okay, William. ¿Le gusta el trabajo o is it very heavy?
Eso es lo que sí, le entendí que me preguntaba si me gustaba. Pero sí, me gusta lo que hago.
You do.
Disfruto.
Okay. You enjoy it, okay. Acuérdese, William, que cuando usted escucha la pregunta, por ejemplo, do you like it? Usted va a contestar con el mismo do. Si fuese afirmativo, usted me va a decir, yes, I do.
Uh-huh.
Okay. Si es negativo, usted me diría, no, I don't. Pero siempre lleva el do con el not, ¿verdad? Para hacerlo, el don't. Entonces, siempre tiene que, acuérdese de esto siempre, William, tiene que escuchar con qué auxiliar le están haciendo la pregunta y con ese mismo va a contestar. Si yo le dijera, did you go to... To San Salvador yesterday. Estamos hablando en pasado. Cuando escuche did, es pasado. Entonces, did you go? Si usted fue a San Salvador.
Didn't.
No, I didn't. Exacto. O si fue, usted me dice, yes, I did.
Yes, I did.
Si fuera en futuro, yo le digo, will you go to San Salvador? Usted me va a decir, yes, I will. Yes. O no, I will not. ¿Verdad? Okay. Entonces, siempre es como, esa es como una clave, William, de siempre escuche el auxiliar con que le hacen la pregunta y con ese mismo va a contestar en afirmativo o en negativo.
Okay.
Para que se le vaya haciendo un poco más fácil. Y si, por ejemplo, le pregunto la famosa where do you work? El where se antepone el auxiliar, pero el auxiliar ahí va, siempre sigue ahí, where do.
Es el do.
Exacto. Entonces, ahora, como le están preguntando where, que es lugar, obviamente usted va a decir, I work at American Park, ¿verdad? Ya no dice el do en la respuesta porque no es una sí o no, sino que le está preguntando dónde trabaja, ¿verdad? Pero si las preguntas son cerradas de sí o no, usted puede contestar con el mismo auxiliar en yes o no. ¿Okay? All right, yes. William, yo sé que está súper cansado. Váyase a dormir. All right.
Gracias.
Very good, very good, William. Pase buenas noches.
Gracias, igual.
Oye, siga que va avanzando. Lo felicito por el gran esfuerzo que hace, oye.
Ok, gracias.
All right, very good.
Hasta el martes.
Ok, yes, bye.
Bye.